are back for round two of Greg Whitfield and Ken Gaines. Put your hands together.
Got a spot here. I'm going to move this, so just that let that. Thanks for sticking around for the
by the way,
the nasty set.
They're going to come back next year, too, so.
Yeah, we're going to do this.
Thanks for the warning.
This is one of those professions that you really do have to work hard at it. I tell people that yes, I am talented. I have two talents. And both of them have stood me in good stead with music business. One of them, I can carry a tune, and I think that's a talent. I really do. The other one is I'm a good sleeper. That's real important when you're out on the road, to be able to sleep anywhere. Get it while you can. I get to be on stage with people like Greg Whitfield here, so. It's gravy. Been a million miles if I've been one. Got a million more before I'm done. And I lost my way a time or two, but I never let it spoil the view. Had a broken back, broken toes, a broken heart, a broken nose. I hit the skids, hit the dirt, hit the road so hard. Can you see it on my face? Can you see it on my face? I think the sweetest water's at the bottom of the well. You know, it's seen the light, it's been through hell. And the sweetest song I ever heard was the song of a wounded bird. I lost my faith, lost my soul, found my God with a fishing pole. Lost my mama, lost my dad, lost my childhood home. Can you see it on my face? I've been burned, a little trace of every lesson that I've learned, right here on my face. Can you see it on my face? Can you see it on face? That is a true story. Greg, you're looking pretty young, buddy.
I'm older than I was yesterday.
Yeah, that's true. That's a good thing. That's a good thing.
There's some comedian that said he hates it when people come up to him and hand him a picture and say, "This is a picture of me when I was younger." He says, "Man, every picture of you is a picture of you when you were younger."
Yeah, so what?
He said he likes digital cameras because it's the only invention that we've ever come up with that allows you to reminisce immediately.
Wow.
My baby understands if I go drinking or if I need a little time alone, and if I want to watch a ball game, she will let me, but I have to make it up when I get home. Those luxuries, they soon come back to haunt me. For every hour I spend on me, I owe her 10. She gets me pulling weeds or doing laundry. In this game of give and take, she always wins. She's charging me interest on her loving. She compounds it daily. I can't seem to get caught up. She's charging me interest on affairs as if I'd had them. And I'm losing interest in her love. Now I know that she trusts me to be faithful. Lord knows I've never strayed, and that's a fact. But if I go out on the town, well, I swear she writes it down. 'Cause she always remembers, and I have to pay her back. She's charging me interest our love. She compounds it daily. I can't seem to get caught up. She's charging me interest like she gave that rib to Adam. And I'm losing interest in her love. She's charging me interest like a doggone Visa Platinum, and I'm losing interest in her love. Yeah, I'm losing interest in her love.
Too smooth. Stay in that key. My version of that key. So.
All right.
I use drop D like a lot of guitar players use E. I don't know why. It's just blame it on Chuck Pyle and then a couple other people. They just first part of the song I stole from John Lee Hooker. First little lick. Everybody else did too. Where he got it. Imagination goes wild. Makes a man wonder what she says in the night. Makes a man wonder what she looks like in the morning light. Wonder, maybe she might. She makes a man wonder, maybe she's wondering too. What's that woman walking around the block? You know you want to follow her home. With all the moves the other girl's got, a couple she calls her own. She's no fool, so plain and cool. It's gonna get you that far. Take a big breath, lay it on the line. Let her know who you are. She makes a man wonder what she says in the night. Makes a man wonder what she looks like in the morning light. Wonder, maybe she might. She makes a man wonder, maybe she's wondering too. My face and said, that's what was on your mind. That you gave a little giggle, a wink and a wiggle, and kissed me on the other cheek. With a wave of her hand, she left me standing and staring for the rest of the week. Makes a man wonder what she says in the night. Makes a man wonder what she looks like in the morning light. Wonder, maybe she might. She makes a man wonder, maybe she's wondering too. What she makes a man wonder, maybe she's wondering too.
Where's Noonie?
In the back.
Oh, good. You found a seat. This is for you. And for my son, Nick, who turned 30 2 weeks ago today. And he's gonna be the drummer on 7 of the tracks on the new album that I'm going to start recording in a couple of weeks. I'm really looking forward to that. And he still hugs me in front of his friends. Seems like only days when half asleep I'd hear you come awake and cry. stumbling to your room, I'd find the table light. And you might need a change or just the company. And I would be there singing, Daddy loves you. And now I see you grow with every passing day. I can see it in your eyes and in the things you say. And the way I fill with pride with every victory makes me want to shout, your daddy loves you. And I hold these times so dear. You return my hugs and kisses, never thinking maybe this is something boys don't do. But the time will come, I fear, when shaking hands replaces tender father-son embraces, 'cause that's what grown men do. But Daddy loves you. Though each act of independence carries you away, I guess nature wouldn't have it any other way. For a father's greatest gift is in the letting go, while he softly cries, your daddy loves you. And I hold these times so dear. In your unrestrained affection, I can see my own reflection in your smiling eyes. For the time will come, I fear, when shaking hands replaces loving father-son embraces, 'cause that's what grown men do. But Daddy loves you. Though each act of independence carries you away, I guess nature wouldn't have it any other way. For a father's greatest gift is in the letting go, while he softly cries, your daddy loves you.
Well, when you get up, hug your mom.
I will. I'll do it right now. Good timing.
You have to do it now.
Should have done it first set. I didn't know Ike was going to leave. My buddy Ike Green here, we used to hang around together in San Antonio a quarter of a century ago. Swap lyrics and poetry, and there are those people that you just feel like you've known them all your life. You don't know why, and it really doesn't matter. But at this one little gathering that we used to go to on a regular basis. It was a weekly poetry music open mic. And I started this next song as a poem from a conversation that Ike and I had had. And I really didn't do much with it as a song until about a year and a half, maybe 2 years later. I was working with a children's theater group and kind of all poured out for a number of different reasons. I wrote it for my daddy, but a couple of years back, I was doing the Wildflower Festival, and I just gotten reunited with Ike and, you know, had them out as my guests at the Wildflower Festival. And I realized, damn, he's never heard this song. So I gave some sort of a introduction like I'm giving you now to this, where a good part of the song came from. Real men don't like lawyers. Real men don't like rules. Real men would rather kick your ass than sue. Real men scare each other. Real men don't complain. Real men shoulder everybody's pain. Real men fight with the flood of their emotions. Love to watch real women walking by. Real men lose their innocence in wars across the ocean. Real men think their fathers never die. They just can't seem to tell that man goodbye. Real men don't ask directions, so they stand out in the cold. Real men need real women more than gold. Real men don't say nigger. And real men don't say die. Real men love their babies more than Jesus. And real men lay their dreams aside in quiet desperation. Learn to build a wall around their hearts. Real men long to live their lives in love and contemplation, but they just can't find a place and time to start. Up and married, and their sons are old enough to be men too. But mostly all alone at night with the burden that they carry, 'cause this world it just won't let them do. What a real man's gotta do. Shirts in it.
Or at least bumper stickers.
Let's talk. I'm not a good marketing purpose. I'm going to kick your ass in
suit. Bumper stickers, t-shirts, buttons.
I just never, you know, I really need to get into this retail sales thing more. I really do. It's just, oh yeah. Yeah, well, it's on the website, but the T-shirt, I never thought of that line.
Okay, it's probably not going to be this next one, unless we just get lucky, because I've already tuned and put a capo on.
In a little while, I'd love to hear Mark's song.
Okay.
You can't get out of here without hearing
Mark's. Yeah, I don't think I've ever done one of these without doing that song, sooner or later.
You want to play it on this guitar?
Yeah, actually. I heard it segged with Guy Clark's the guitar, you know, that song
of
his?
Yeah.
About the pawn shop and minor key thing that Verlin Thompson plays so well on. And I was listening to KUT Radio in Austin, and that song, that Guy Clark song was on. I was like, oh, yeah, I love this fucking song. It's great. When it faded out, they played Martin's song after.
That's pretty cool.
That's pretty cool.
Well, if you get to hear a guy anytime soon, just go for it, okay? Because he's not doing too well, and it's hard for him to finish a show. But, you know, on the flip side of that, Verlin's still just out there kicking. And
he's amazing.
He's doing shows on his own, and he does that song like only Verlin can. Yep. That's all there's to it.
There ain't nothing like a back porch and a second cup of coffee on a summer Sunday morning with the radio on. And my thoughts tend to wander to nowhere in particular while I begin to hum along to an old love song. I wonder what it'd be like if I ever won the lottery. I wonder what I'd spend that kind of money on. 'Cause there's nothing on my wish list that I don't already have, and I've had it all along. I know I'm a simple man, and I like to have my downtime. Not much holds a candle to a lazy afternoon. And I don't recall the last time I was ever in a hurry. And I don't recall the last time that I wanted something new. The old car's running pretty well, got a little money put away. And the woman that I love knows all the words to my songs. Can't say that there's anything that I really gotta have, 'cause I've had it all along. That's not to say I don't enjoy a road trip now and then, but it don't take too long before I'm headed home again. In the glider on my back porch, and a cold can of Heineken, and the woman that I dream about sitting by my side. We listen to the birds sing as the sun slowly fades away, and the day begins to give way to another summer night. Some say that I might be a little undermotivated, but I tend to disagree. I believe they're wrong. There's nothing that I really need that I don't already have, and I've had it all along. Thank you.
You guys should take this to our national.
All right. I'm ready. You know what?
Hey, Ken, let me ask you this. How do you feel about the brown M&Ms?
Brown M&M's just fine with me.
You know, I'm for them.
You know,
we can take this on the road.
It's fine with me. I can do that. But you, what, you want all the rest?
Because now we won't need separate buses.
I've never been asked that question before.
Some people feel strongly.
You know, that's probably a good question to ask a person you're thinking about marrying. Never thought about that either.
One of my kindergartners the other day told me, Mr. Whitfield, what'd the hat say, the scarf? I said, what? Because we had cold weather. You know, they all brought hats and scarves and gloves. And one little girl said, I have ear gloves. Anyway, the kid said, what'd the hat say, the scarf? I said, I don't know what. And he goes, you hang around, I'll go on ahead. That's some funny shit.
That's
right there.
Funny. That's funny shit. That's it. We don't do this alone. I don't care. We don't do this alone. Anybody says he does it alone is a liar, or they're not going to last long. That's all there's to it. And if I'd learned to take suggestions like yours a long time ago, y'all wouldn't be able to afford me. But No, we are who we are, and I'm right where I need to be, and I won't get out of here if I don't do this song here.
You should come to my back porch. You'd never get off.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. It's a good porch. You're you got invited, a good view, man. Way. That's it. I'm looking forward to it. That'd be fun. Porch. Oh man. This is an F sharp. I got room.
Ooh. Cool.
I teach a number of songwriter seminars these days. They're kind of theme specific. One of them's called The Power of Contrast. Now think about the last song I sang and put it in context with this one. Everybody got their favorite dish. Hot buttered muffins at the top of my list. 'Cause I love muffins. Hot buttered muffins from the oven. Nothing said loving like hot buttered muffins from the oven. Now you can have your cake and eat it too. Give me hot buttered muffins and I'll stay with you. Love them muffins, hot buttered muffins from the oven. But nothing said loving like hot buttered muffins from the oven. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Tell us, Greg. Buttered muffins from the oven. Nothing said loving like hot buttered muffins from the oven. Well, you just open that muffin, slip that butter on in. Take
great big bite. Get it all over your chinny chin chin. Wipe that smile off your face, cause nothing said loving like hot buttered muffins from your van. Do it again, Greg. For Greg Whitfield, making this song much longer and much sweeter. How many folks have never heard this song before? Raise your hand. Probably figured it out though, right? Don't you think I ought to be selling this song to Pillsbury? Can't you see the Pillsbury Doughboy singing this song wearing sunglasses, Kenny Cash and royalty checks? I love it, singing Doughboy. I'm butter your biscuits and I'm butter your buns and butter your muffin till the morning comes. I love muffins, hot buttered muffins from the oven. There's nothing said loving like hot buttered muffins from the oven. Take it home. Well, nothing said loving like hot buttered muffins from the oven. Power of contrast.
Yeah. That's effective. Well, now that puts the ball in my court.
There you go.
Power of contrast. Let's see. We could go real sad. We could go real fun. Sure. But you know what? That song is about being lazy. And it's only got one verse. So I think it's true. I think it's true to form. I was playing it the other night. I think I was playing with George, and we were just hauling ass. You know, I was thinking, wait a minute, why is this song so hard? It's supposed to be a song about not really lifting a finger. I'm gonna do it a little slower tonight, just in honor of, you know, my birthday and the slow pace that I'm trying to maintain today. And,
well,
it is.
Cool. Well, happy birthday, Greg.
Well, thank you.
That's cool. All right.
This is the best place I could be on my birthday. I absolutely couldn't think.
Well,
I couldn't.
Gotten you a stripper or something.
No.
It could probably still be arranged for that.
You really don't.
Sagittarius.
Yeah. All right. So here we go. A little relaxed version of. And this is comforting thought for those of you that that make lists of stuff that you're going to put off until tomorrow. I stopped to smell the flowers, 7 wasted hours. I have not done a thing all day, but I won't let that bother me. I won't be losing any sleep comes, somebody's doing something somewhere. Well, maybe I should take a nap or read a magazine, or sit here flipping channels, or grab a bite to eat. This lifestyle's sure seductive, but I don't feel unproductive, cause somebody's doing something somewhere.
should do the wash or at least go to the gym. Yeah, probably ought to mow the lawn, but this hammock that I'm in is awfully damn seductive. But I don't feel unproductive, 'cause somebody's doing something somewhere. Somebody's doing something somewhere. Somebody's doing something somewhere.
Somebody's doing someone somewhere.
I like it.
Yeah, I know.
You can take it.
I've heard that before.
Yeah. By the way, I got an email list somewhere out there. I'll put it out. Or become my Facebook friend. I put out these little missives, and I've been doing them a lot lately. And one of my latest ones was, I was talking about doing this little wine bar gig that I do a couple of them a month. And, you know, it's just, I'm there, and sometimes people listen, sometimes they don't, and they feed me decent wine, and I get paid, and that's cool. It really is. It's cool. I played one. This is a couple of weeks ago, and I don't think I've ever sung any better in my life. I was just on. I could just move around, and my mind was clicking with the whole bit, and nobody was listening. Except for me. So when I tune, I hear it. I ain't singing for just you. We make love in the moonlight. Lord help me, the stars begin to fall. All the time we spent together, we've always known we had it all. I know you never really look at me or even guess what's on my mind. Our love is just a little game I play to while away my empty time. 'Cause we make love in the moonlight of my kiss me. Imagination makes me bold.
in my heart I know you can't resist me. My love is in your very soul. I know you never really look at me or even guess what's on my mind. Our love is just a little game I play to while away my empty time. 'Cause we make love in the moonlight of my
been revisiting a lot of my parents really introduced me to a lot of music, and I just thought that's the way you grew up. But I've been revisiting Harold Arlen and Johnny Mercer and you know, and then taking these songs that
Jerome
people
Kern.
Like that they yes and Jerome Kern, and then listening to everybody's version. YouTube is wonderful, folks. Just take a song like Come Rain or Come Shine and listen to everybody's version of it. All these great singers that did this. Just do it and just listen to that. And I realized.
And then imagine being the guy that owns the publishing on that song that all those people have recorded.
Oh.
God, can you imagine riding the Moon River? Mm. Damn.
You guys aren't bad.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, it's like bad
song.
Yeah.
That y'all do. You've already written the river. It's just that I haven't picked it up.
Well,
that's true.
There aren't too many people like Johnny.
The word to a few people and
that's right.
Yeah.
Then, do you really want
to? I got to tell you though, just I don't know. Yeah. That Tony Bennett won't call you back.
Yeah, we live in a t-shirt world now, so you know.
Cozy's,
yeah.
He can
set y'all up. Yeah. I never would have thought of that. Somebody had to. That's why I think about like Einstein. I mean, we would have come up with that stuff. It's just that he got there first and maybe considerably quicker than most. I don't know, but we'd have got there.
I think it'd be cool to be Einstein. I think his legacy among many. I mean, come on. Guy's a genius. But I think his legacy is that when you really want to insult someone with ultimate sarcasm about their stupidity, you call them Einstein. I think that's a hell of a legacy there.
Yeah. Sooner or later,
that'd be like them going like 100 years from now. Nice guitar lick, Whitfield. That'd be so cool. That'd be so cool for your grandkids. They could do it at school, you know.
Pretty soon, Einstein's name it probably already is. It'll become a verb. You Einstein it. I Einsteined it.
I think it already has with the Einsteins.
Yeah.
But we digress.
We do.
We do that.
And that's the beauty of a house concert. The opportunity for
we
digression.
Know how.
You mastered it.
I was made by loving hands in Nazareth, Pennsylvania, the winter time of 1939.
And the hands that shape my sides and back have long since been forgotten. But I was built to stand the test of time. I was given to a young man for his high school graduation. And for a time, I rarely left his side. I helped him learn music of his hero, Woody Guthrie. We had a fine existence, he and I. Then the army called his number, shipped him off to the Pacific, and he never made it home to me again. I was packed away in storage, and the silence nearly killed me. His parents did not seem to understand. That all I ever wanted were two hands upon my strings, somebody who knew just enough to make my rosewood sing. My worth is only measured by the pleasure that I bring to the one who has his hands upon the strings, to the one who has his hands upon the strings. Country singer paid a fortune just to hang me on a wall. And I appeared on album covers, and I was on the Grand Ole Opry, but he never even played a note at all. Then the IRS came calling, I was rescued from my prison, moved to Liverpool in 1983. I was played and scratched and borrowed, I was pawned and I was stolen, but none of these things mattered much to me. 'Cause all I ever wanted were two hands upon my strings, somebody who knew just enough to make my rosewood sing. My worth is only measured by the pleasure that I bring to the one who has hands upon the strings, to the one who has his hands upon the strings. Thank you.
I just want to let that moment linger.
You're sitting one, you know, you got one in your lap.
How I do. Cool is that? It's not that old. It's another generation. But, yeah, this is my high school graduation present.
Thank
Real
you
cool.
Stock.
Didn't we just fall in love?
I could do that.
Yeah. The title right up so bad with yes.
those. I can do that. We'll do another one. Are you ready for another one in F?
Oh, yeah, of course.
I've become very familiar with F.
I discovered the key of F. I forget who.
This right, the major seventh. But
this
great.
Is another one. This is another one of songs. I mean, I was one of those little kids who knew who Johnny Mercer and Hoagie Carmichael was when I was a little kid. People say, well, you know, who wrote Stardust? Well, Carmichael's music. He didn't write the lyrics, but I did grow up in the folk rock era, and I didn't learn these chords right away. But I was singing those songs. It's interesting. I was just kind of reliving the, you know, kind of my early 20s when I was playing this guitar in nightclubs 5 nights a week, Simon and Garfunkel songs on the breaks of the adult bands. And man, I just hanging around listening to those adult bands and reliving some of those songs. And, you know, I'd start singing along, and eventually these John Thomas and Art DiOrio, and they'd say, well, you know that song? Well, come on up and sing it. And I would sing with these guys, and it was just, oh, just tasting those lyrics, the way they tumble off out of your throat and over your tongue and out there, and just listen to them, you know, the way the notes sustain and where you clip them and stuff like that. And, oh. So I never would have been able to write a song like this without that kind of experience. And I learned the chords a little bit later. It might have been the night, might have been the moon, might have been the sight of other lovers in the room, might have been my imagination, but didn't we just fall in love? Could have been a sigh, could have been a song, could have been the wine to help the mood along. Could have been the combination. Didn't we just fall in love? Unless it's just some little thing I missed. Best guess it must have been first time we kissed, with so much sweet temptation to fall in love. Yeah, I should have seen it coming, should have smelled perfume, should have heard the humming of bees around the bloom, should have known that old sensation. Didn't we just fall in love? Unless it's just some little thing I missed. Best guess it must have been the first time we kissed.
sweet temptation, fall in love. Y'all should have seen it coming, should have smelled perfume, should have heard the humming of bees around the bloom, should have known that old sensation, didn't we just fall in love, didn't we just fall in love, didn't we just fall in love?
Oh. That was nice.
Ken.
Yeah.
Remember I told you how to make better tips tonight?
Oh. No, I didn't remember.
Well, there's a few people that I think are waiting for that.
Whatever it is.
Are you? Is it involved?
There you go. Hey, it's showbiz.
I used to be able to do that.
Yeah, I know you did. It's showbiz, yeah. Buddy.
That's yeah, I know. Kindergarten.
Yeah.
Speaking of kindergarten. Yes.
All right. It's,
now tell them why you don't have
time for the song.
Tell
them why you don't have.
Yes.
Why I don't have what?
Your why hair. You don't have long hair anymore?
Oh, it's hopefully it's a wig by now. Oh, surely it is by now.
Yeah.
For a kid with cancer, it's a an organization. It's kind
of
like Locks of Love, but yeah. You know they charge some patients for their wigs.
Really?
But but there was an organization in Robin went online and found all the, and started comparing them, and there was an organization called Wigs for Kids that only made wigs for children, I guess under the age of 12 or whatever the cutoff, you know. But they made wigs, and they had more stringent kind of length requirements, and it had to be from rubber band to rubber band, had to be 12 inches, so it had to be really about 14 inches long.
Mm-hmm.
And then it had to be clean and washed and dried and braided and four little Willie Nelson-looking things that were kind of scary-looking. When I held them up, and it was like, and it was hard to find a hairstylist that was willing to jump through all those hoops and fill out all the forms. And but I found somebody who was the one that cuts Robin's hair, and so that happened. And it was fun. I no longer feel like Dharma's dad when I put on a Hawaiian shirt. Here's a song about art. Not a guy named Art. It's just art. Art in general. This is from Buddy Art. You know who you are. But it's actually about it's about beauty more than anything. And the passage of time and how time doesn't necessarily pose a negative. Depends on what time's working on. Sometimes time can be a friend as opposed to a deteriorating factor. This is called Picture of Beauty. Picture of beauty I never knew. A vision so lovely could love me too and make me the envy of all who see, and leave them to guess what this one so fine could see in this man, and they wonder why they can't have one too. For their very own, this picture of beauty, you. Mm-hmm.
us fine. The works of a master will fade with time. And sooner or later we'll cease to be. But God in his infinite mystery created a beauty that grows with time. And for reasons unknown, this treasure is mine. What a lovely view, this picture of beauty. Sunlight, stars bright, colors of changing hue. No man's skilled hands ever could capture you. Look at you, the picture of beauty, a dream come true. A glimpse into heaven, an answered prayer, the wish of a lifetime beyond compare. A vision of beauty that grows with time. And for reasons unknown, this treasure is mine. What a lovely this picture of beauty you.
I could hear Nat King Cole singing that. Oh, gosh. My earliest memories were of Nat Cole and his TV show. Before he became Nat King Cole, the TV host, he had this trio that was just dynamic, just incredible. And then a lot of that's on YouTube as well. And he was an incredible pianist. He really was. I mean,
really?
On YouTube. Just go for it. Go look at him. Him and his trio with a bass player and a guitar player. And every once in a while they have somebody else sitting in. Like they'll have Wayne Tebow coming in to do Caravan or something like that. You know, oh, God, just go on YouTube. Go look for that stuff. It's there. Oh, man. So it wasn't all jazz stuff and everything, because I really did get a lot of twang in my background. And I did write this song with George Jones in mind. Damn it. And could have made us both happy, you know. But it is a sing-along. It's one of those choruses. That's what you write these choruses for. One of those sing-alongs. Jump in there. It don't take that much. Yesterday it's just an old McCartney love song. Yesterday it's just a picture on the wall. And the truth is the truth will never set you free. 'Cause it's just the truth that only recalls yesterday's lost and gone forever. Although you still may remember that old song, there is no place in the soul world so far away as yesterday. Mm-hmm. You know time can take the edges off of memories, just like the river takes the edges off a stone. You can go blind from staring at the sun too long, or go crazy if you live your life alone. Yesterday, lost and gone forever. Although you still may remember that old song, there is no place in the soul world so far away.
This particular song, it's good timing, you know, it's the time of year. George and I wrote this, George Inslee and I wrote this. And I'm proud of this one, I think it's cool. It tells of a true story of a sort of an impromptu truce that happened in the trenches on Christmas Eve, in the trenches of the first year, 1914, the first year of World War I in Belgium. And it was music that prompted the truce.
The Belgian night was filled with stars, not fire from our guns. We heard the Christmas carols from the trenches being sung. The words we did not understand, but the melodies were clear. They were the same ones we had learned back in our childhood years. Soon we joined in with them and sang in harmony with the boys a day ago we'd killed as enemies. But when we sang together of our blessed Savior's birth,
There for a time for all mankind, we knew peace on earth. Now it's three on a match, boys, tonight we'll have no fear. Tommy and Fritz, boys, you share a Christmas cheer. Let the generals give their orders from the Kaiser and the King. It's for the Prince of Peace, boys, tonight we're gonna sing. It's for the Prince of Peace, boys, tonight we're gonna sing. The Christmas dawn, they left their trenches, shovels in their hands, to bury their dead brothers in a frozen no man's land. One by one we dropped our guns, climbed out to do the same. We put our boys in frozen soil with crosses without names. The dreaded Huns were boys like us, looking like old men, whose shattered lives fought to survive like candles in the wind. Shell shock from the rounds of our artillery we threw, snuffed out by snipers' bullets, diphtheria and flu. But when we shook their hands, suddenly there was no war. We played a game of soccer and we heard the birds once more. Shared cigarettes and stories of our loved ones left behind, and how each day we prayed we get to see them one more time. Now it's three on a match, boys, tonight we'll have no fear. Cause Tommy and Fritz, boys, are sharing Christmas cheer. Let the generals give their orders from the Kaiser and the King. It's for the Prince of Peace, boys, tonight we're gonna sing. It's for the Prince of Peace, boys, tonight we're gonna sing. They had to move us down the line, cause we refused to fire on the boys that we had sung with in our ragtag Christmas choir. We remembered on that day what he was sent here for, and we prayed that this would be the war to end all wars. Now it's three on a match, boys, tonight we'll have no fear. Tommy and Fritz, boys, are sharing Christmas cheer. Let the generals give their orders from the Kaiser and the King. It's for the Prince of Peace, boys, tonight we're gonna sing. It's for the Prince of Peace, boys, tonight we're gonna sing. It's for the Prince of Peace, boys, tonight we're gonna sing.
So I got one more left in me, and I'm sure Greg does too. Actually, I'm just
before the triple encore.
Yeah. Actually, I'm just getting started. Damn it. So I talk about my mom a lot, and I think that's proper. But I was just as close to my daddy. My daddy was a beautiful man, and he was no more beautiful than when he was wade fishing.
That does bring out the charm in a man, doesn't it?
And I realized that one time in my late 20s when went out fishing with Dad, and they lived down in Biloxi, Mississippi, and we were out fishing in front of the there wasn't a pier there then, but every now and then there's a pier out from what used to be the White House Hotel, and the storms take those out all the time, but I just know where it is. And the pylons are there, and it's always a good place to fish. And I went out there fishing with Dad, and he was saying, you know, this morning's a good time to wear your long pants. And I said, nah, I can. He says, them sea nettles are going to get you. And so we waited out just before sunrise, and damn it. You know what sea nettles are?
Yes.
Okay, this is the jellyfish. They're, you know, they're like a miniature Portuguese man of war, and they sting the crap out of you. And they were in, and damn it, man, they were just hitting me and hitting me. And I thought, you know, he's right. So I trudged back up to the van and got my long pants and I put them on and sitting out on the seawall as the sun's coming up. Dad's out there fishing and he's, there's the sun and there's my dad right in the middle of it. And Dad could chunk a mirror lure a mile. God, it was beautiful. And I said, I'm gonna remember this. Fast forward, 25, 30 years. Mind, I see my father cast his line, silhouetted in the rising sun. A single dancer in the light, a simple melody in flight, the song begins as the dance is done. Cast your troubles upon the water. Let them flow into the sea. Live your life as if this morning was all the sunlight you'll ever see. Wrestling demons in the night, should I run or should I fight? Am I forgiven for the things I've done? In the quiet thunder of the dawn, I know the memory and the song, Dad and the ocean dancing as one. Cast your troubles on the water, let them flow to the sea. Live your life as if this morning was all the sunlight you'll ever see. As I ponder these simple graces, I find a peace that I can embrace. Cast your troubles upon the water. If this morning was all the sunlight you'll ever see. very much. Thank you, Randy.
All right, Don and Marky. Promised you this. I can't begin to tell you what an amazing. I don't think you'll. They don't get it. I mean, they can't.
Yeah.
Because you have to do. You have to be in these chairs to sort of get how cool this is. I know it's cool. I've been in those chairs and watched other songwriters that I really enjoyed their songs and think, God, what a great deal this is. You know, but this space and the quality of how it sounds in here and the willingness of people to show up and really listen and be open-minded. And I mean, it
really is about love.
It's amazing. It's humbling. It's an amazing thing that you do here. It's amazing. And it is the best gig of the year. And it really is. It's the one I look forward to. I mean, last year was December 15th when we played. I was sitting here saying, boy, I can't wait till next year. And that was exactly a year ago tomorrow.
December 13th next year.
So the 13th next year. Put it on your calendar. But thank you so much. I can't thank you enough. It's the coolest thing for a songwriter to be able, I mean, you know this, to have a room full of people that are hearing the word choice. I mean, those word choices are, they didn't just happen. I mean, you had choices. That's why they're called word choices. And the cool thing is the really good ones choose well. You know, and so you want to know, you want to have an audience of people that appreciate your word choice and your how long you hung on the minor for, you know. You really want that, and you don't find that very often. But you find it here every time you come here, no matter who's playing here. And, man, am I lucky to get to play along with Ken. Don and Marky, where are you? There you are. Time falls away and seem to fade, but not for me, for I have you to share them all and hold on to the years we walked down different roads have led us here. Now I know that it was always meant to be me for you and you for me. You and I, it seems, are one another. Has brought us home as one and last, forever on. The years we walked down different roads have led us here, and now I know that it was all meant to be me for you and you for me.
so I come to you and offer peace and hope and light. I give to you my heart and soul with all my strength and all my might. The years we walked down different roads have led us here, and now I know that it was always meant to be. For you and you for me. Now I know it was meant to be me for you and you for me.
Whitfield.
Ken Gaines. Yeah, man.
Merry Christmas. Thank you, brother. Thank you. We haven't worn you guys out yet.
I requested two songs from them that they didn't do tonight, so stay with me for two more songs. Well, but that's tough, y'all.
Oh yeah, we don't have.
Haven't worn you guys out yet.
That might be what I asked.
It'll happen. One of my latest jokes. Is about this writing thing is it's not really a joke. Cuz it's the truth. Cuz it's about being able to tell the truth. And after you I tell people you live long enough and you don't have to make this stuff up. You just have to make it rhyme. Never quite got over Woodstock or November 63. The things I learned at 21, put a big old hole in me. Never worried much about the bomb. Not a whole lot I could do. Never get over losing Mom.
never get over you. Never quite forget Lee Remick's eyes. And baby, the rain must fall. I'll never forget my baby's cries and the pain I caused them all. Never stop wanting a lover's touch and all the things that lovers do. Never stop having to feel so much, 'cause I'll never get over you. Some say that nothing lasts forever, but don't believe it's true. Love's the one thing that will never disappear from view. We become the love we keep alive after everything is through. So the only way I will survive is to never get over you. Never stop loving this old guitar and all the things it got me through. I never stop being a wandering star, and I'll never get over you. No, I'll never get over you.
Greg Whitfield. Just make it rhyme.
Here we go. This is for you, Randy. Randy liked this the day I wrote it. It's always been his favorite. And it is a weird chord progression, I gotta admit. Full moon
horizon and paints the sea a silver blue. He begins to hum a Caribbean tune. He looks into her eyes and says it all, just one side. It's so hard to say goodbye to this paradise and the island life. She would trade it all for a single reason why. He asked her once again to come along with him and leave her home behind. She knows too well the paradise is hard to find. Seaplane rises and fades away to the sun. Turns to walk along the beach alone. And now this tiny island is no longer feels like home at all. And the tears begin to fall. This island is no longer paradise. But she threw it all aside. How could she have failed to see? Home is where the heart can beat as one with another. Yeah, paradise is hard to find.
Once again, it's paradise.